make loss, and also we reduce our business, and or we can fail in our business. So for that, making brand, making market, and also selling the product in the market, because every time there will be demand. So for that, we require QA and tester. And testing is a process of evaluating a system or its component with the intent to find that whether it is satisfy the specified requirement or not. So whenever we are getting requirement from the client side, so we ensure that everything, every feature, every functionality is working properly. It should work properly, then our client will be happy and also our customers should be happy. If suppose anyone having some issues like related to product, so it will be very bad impression to the industries also. So for that, we can ensure that our quality and product should be proper. There will not difference in there or any making some issues or rumor will be not happen anything. So that kind of situation everyone is facing, and they're reducing and also making the quality of the products. So in this there we will today in because this is a demo, so I'm summarizing the thing, but from tomorrow onward when you would like to start this training full-fledged, so we will discuss each topic in detail. So here there's something in information about testing. So testing is only process to evaluate the system, it's matching the requirement or not, whatever coming from the client. Okay, and there will be VLV methodology will be approaching, and the verification validation will be there. So this verification validation is a main thing when we are following that SDLC technique some approach. So left side, if you see there, we are creating some V-shaped model. V-shaped model, it means, as you know, SDLC is having six phases. There will be requirement phase, then design phase, then coding phase, then testing, then implementation, then maintenance. Okay, so this is a phase. So in each phase, we are having huge work on that. When we are getting requirements, so we do analysis. Then in according to that analysis, our technical panel will be designed. BRD, then BRD is coming from our marketing team. According to that BRD, that's business requirement, we are preparing our FHD functional requirement specification. Then we can create our DFD, that's data flow diagram, USD, use case diagram, entity relationship. So those kind of work we can start when we getting the requirement from the client. So this is done from development team, and also in the beginning of that assignment requirement, our QA team and tester team also involve that projects. So they will also understand the requirement, and after getting the requirement, understanding the requirement, they do some impact analysis, because that requirement coming from the client, so there will be some mismatch or mistake will be there, some functionality will be breaking somewhere. So those kind of impact analysis will be going on, and according to that BRD, they will prepare his test plan, test strategies, and after that they will design test cases. So that will be a part of QA side, and after hitting the use case, develop and designer will be a process, and they will design the web, that application according to that requirement, and also some creativity going on behind the project. Okay.
So what will be the test cases? How you will generate the test case?
Yeah,
the project is still under, it's not into development, right? It is still in a requirement phase where you are collecting the requirement from the client, and how you are writing the test cases then?
The test case should be the tester can write through BRD only. they will understand, first they will understand the functionality, where will the functionality, what the use case, as per the functionality of that application, also that will be compatibility. Then if suppose they see in the requirement, also they will define the which kind of browser they will require, like and they will test the Firefox, Chrome, Internet Explorer, or Safari, or Opera. So which kind of browser they would like to, and which kind of testing they would prefer. Like functional testing happen every time, but security testing also required, and that load test will be there. So according to this kind of testing, we can prepare our test cases.
Okay.
And also that will be depend upon feature to feature. So that will be very easy to create our test cases when we are getting some technical documents from that project manager or technical architect.
Okay.
Because they will design a functional requirement document, and also they will design use case. So so with the help of this use case and functional design document, we can prepare our test case very easily.
So test case, it is you write it in some specific software, or you write it in Word or Excel, something like that.
So see, that will be depend upon the organization. If suppose you are working with some similar 5 organization, so they will approaching some software, some tools like TFS, Jira, Bugzilla, and also there will be multiple test management tool will be there, like Quality Center.
Okay.
Okay. So they will approach those kind of tools, and after getting these test cases, testers should wait until the development completed, because development team taking some time to doing enhancement of create application, and after that they will do his work, and after completing the and integrating that application, they will send and release for few release, that should be build one. So it will come to play that QA start his work and do testing and do execution of that whatever written test cases in his system. So one by one they will execute, and in that execution we do a smoke test, then sanity test, then retest will be there. So according to that we can complete our scenario, and so there will be bug life cycle will be also reach available in that side, because whenever we are posting some bug, and at the same time developer working on that application, and he will fix it, and after fixing it he will send again to test that application for closing the bug. So this kind of cycle will be created. The cycle we are calling is a bug life cycle or defect life cycle we are calling. So this is overall, and after completion of this process, we can create one report that's like that's called the test report. So in that report we can mention our all active bug or closed bug, or if suppose there will be default state, there will be number of state like active, inactive, deferred, and new, close. So this kind of status we are having, then priority, CRT, and terminology we are also using. So priority will be defined by a development team, and CRT will be defined by priority will be defined by us, the QA team, and CRT will be defined by marketing team or developer, business team, actually say. So we will discuss on that also later on, and there will be, we are also preparing that some SDLC process will be there, whatever I told you, like that in the SDLC side, similar way we are following into SDLC. That's the SDLC is for our development side, and SDLC is into our testing for QA. Okay. So there will be, you can see here, 9th topic, there will be test case, use case, and scenario. So different between these three. So test cases is nothing but you can say input parameter. There will be number of test cases. There will be, according to our feature, we can create our test cases. And use case will be use case means one into flow. One person, like we would like to go for withdraw some money in into ATM. So what activities, what action we are performing into that ATM machine. So that thing will be completed in our the requirement section, the FSD section. And scenario means we are this is a combination of multiple test cases. We are calling as a test scenario. So there we also before creating the test cases and the use case, test plan and test schedule prepare. So test strategy generally prepared by test manager.
Can we do test case again? I'm having little confusion over it. What is test case?
Can you mute your microphone actually? So that's why that will be great for me.
Okay, sorry.
Yeah. So test is nothing but you can say that was one. I think that's an input parameter where we can define our different steps. What was our step will be like execution step. That's what is expected result and. All description step objective of the test in the step what was the following step will be there like suppose there will be one login section there will be username field and password field and the login button. Okay, so there will be one is a login scenario. We can call a group of test cases called a test scenario. Okay, and use case means there will be one use case like there will be define a person how they will interact with the system. Like one person, suppose you are sitting in front of your system and you are entering some value in that username field and entering password field and click the login button, then you can move to your, if suppose the password and credential is valid, so you can move to your dashboard section or my account section. So this is one role play use can say is a use case. And test case, when we are preparing test case, so in test case there will be different criteria we have to complete it. Like if we can check the functionality that of that field, like if empty field will be there, like we are not putting any input in that username field and password field, just click login button. So after clicking login button, we should get some validation error message. We should not move to our dashboard my account section without credential. So this is one test case. And second test case, you can check the length, how that text box is accepting some value or not. Okay. Each field, username field and password field. So there's a second test case. And also when we are entering some invalid credential for username and password and clicking the login section, so they will also display validation messages like this is not matching your credential, not matching your database. This kind of error message they will display. So for each step, we are writing some sentence. This is called test case. Like it will be your test input parameter. And there will be a principle of testing. So in the principle of testing, you can see that how the pesticide and also testing criteria will be there. So there will be different principle available in the in this software testing. Okay, so generally you can see in testing principle like testing is too expensive, time consuming and cannot be started if a product is not fully developed. Complete testing is not possible. If the software is tested, then it must be bug free. Anyone can test software application. Tested task is only to find bug. So main principle of our QA side is finding a bug. How we do does not matter, but for tester main objective is we have to find bug in that application. Okay, and then we can start then our here the 10th 11th top 10th topic you see here, how to prepare test plan. So test plan and test strategy, there will be two different document. Test strategy will be developed by test manager and the test plan will be prepared by the QA lead or test lead. So project plan is depend upon our project, but strategy should be followed by every project. Okay, this is a you can say this is a quality control and this is quality assurance. Okay, so quality control and quality assurance, I think you know, by like quality control there will be one you can say activities which in quality control we can ensure that verification to develop software with respect to document and whatever requirement coming from the client. And quality assurance means we can ensure the implementation of process and procedure and standard whatever we set it for development of software. So we can control our quality in entire time whenever we are getting some requirement for each requirement we have prepared. We can move for with same strategy, but project plan will be your test plan should be different. Like see, in test plan some client coming and giving our business and saying us we would like to test this product as manual plus automation, and second client coming us and they will say yes, only we do manual testing. So strategy for the testing should be same for these two projects, but plan will be different because one is taking long time because there will be one another approach we are finding at the automation site, and the second is only manual testing. So for second project will be delivered as soon as compared to that manual plus automation site. So this is a difference of you can say test plan and test strategy. We'll also discuss later on when we coming one by one in these topics. Okay, so also I will give you some live example of how can we prepare test cases, how what is the standard format of writing the test cases, that's a template you can say. Okay, and what is the error, bug and the defect and failure, what is the difference between these four terms, because whenever we are saying what is the error and how can we define the failure of the applications. So there will be very very small differences in these four terms, because if this normal term we are also saying there will be failure, there will be error, that's why it's failed. So there will be small differences in these four terms, and there will be test case techniques. How can we create our test case as you asked one question just a minute back. So this will be our main criteria also in this BRD or FSD. There will be defined that function also. So according to that, boundary value analysis, equivalence partition, decision table, standard transaction diagram, use case testing. So this kind of test case also we can prepare in our test cases. Boundary value analysis, like suppose in text there will be one text box that apply value only between 100 to 200. Okay, so for that boundary value, how we can test our boundary value? It will accept only 100 to 200, so we can check for 99 100 then 201 201. So this is called, one second. So this is called our boundary value analysis. And equivalence partitioning. Equivalence partitioning means there will be some partition will be there. Suppose we are having some field and we would like to partition it. So how can we test those applications? Suppose I am asking one question. If suppose one candle is there, okay, and that candle is we burn, and it will taking exact 1 hour to complete burn. So if suppose we are not having any kind of instrument or watch with in front of us or with us, how can we say this is exact 30 minutes completed? Hello?
Hello, sorry, can you repeat please? I was just writing something. Yeah.
Yeah, means I am asking one question, like see, for equivalence partition. There's one logic question. See, one candle with us. There is nothing with us, like some watches, some another instrument, some centimeter scale, something. There is no. Only we are having one matchbox and one candle.
Mm-hmm.
And the candle is taking exact 1 hour for burn.
Mm-hmm.
After 1 hour, the candle is finished burning. So
okay.
And after that, how can we check exact half an hour completed?
If the candle is into halfway.
How can we cut it out?
It's
because
melted.
We are not.
It's melted. Right, approximately
we
can say.
It is melt, the candle is taking 1 hour for melt.
Yeah, so 1 hour, in half an hour it will melt half, right?
So how can we judge that's the half? Exact half an hour.
We will mark it before it burns.
No, yes, I understand, but how can we mark it? There is no such option or measurement with us.
We have to do approximate. We won't get 100%, but approximate result.
No, we can get 100% result from one way.
Mm-hmm.
See,
mm-hmm.
What we can do, there will be when we burn when we burn this candle in two way, like two both side.
Mm-hmm.
So it will see. It will take 1 hour for melt.
Mm-hmm.
If suppose we burn both side at a time, so it will take half an hour.
Okay.
So this way, so. Yes. So similar way we are doing some for some functional testing application. Okay. So for same way we are doing testing for functional specification for equivalence partition, and also some state transaction diagram will be there. And use case testing, like whatever use case we are getting from the BAT, that's a business analyst. So we can follow in that, and then we will see one by one also when we completed this session. And as I told you, like there's a bug life cycle is introduced during our testing cycle, and there will be prepared bug when we are getting bugs, so we can prepare bug defect will be there in type of testing. There will be a lot of testing we have to complete it, and there will be static and dynamic testing will be with coming into this testing site. So static testing, like static is only we can execute our program. There no need to know about programming side. And the dynamic testing, you can say testing can execute the program also. So static testing means black box testing, and dynamic testing means we should know about some programming knowledge, and we do some unit integration testing side, like in like white box testing. So for white box tester, we should know some programming knowledge of that particular development of that application. Suppose that the application developing .NET or Java, so we should know about .NET and Java also. Okay, but for black box testing, there's no need to require any programming knowledge. Only we do and GUI testing in front of us. And there will be some functional testing and non-functional testing. So functional testing means unit testing, integration testing, and non-functional testing, it will be appearing for your usability, load testing, performance testing, security testing, compatibility testing, everything coming under non-functional testing. and also there will be white box testing and black box testing. What is it that I said you, like in this into dynamic and static.
So and all these terminologies are different testings. It's the testing tools or the way it is tested, the program.
Way of testing. Way of testing. There is no testing tool here. There's only it will coming. This is coming in manual test only. Manual test.
Okay. Okay.
There are no specific. This is only types of testing and technique of testing.
Okay. So every software whatever we are making goes through all this test.
Yes. Everything okay. Going on through according to this topic.
Okay.
So there will then integration testing, user acceptance testing. So system integration testing done by our white box tester. And user acceptance testing that will be majorly done by our business analyst, who is project manager. Okay, and there will be entry area and exit criteria will be there. By and at what time QA will be involved for testing, and at what time we should exit from that application. So this thing and the test environment and the test data preparation. So test environment like. There'll be some infrastructure level, like who's responsible for this application for testing, like operating system, database access, and some network activities. So everything that's related to our system. So test environment will be like our system environment should be prepared by infra team, and they would like to give us some access. And also test data preparation, this will be responsible for us for each step or whatever functionality we would like to test. So for that we have to prepare some test document or test data will be there, like alphanumeric character, numeric character, normal character, and some special character will be there. So this kind of approaches we need to follow, and we have to prepare the data. And then there will flow graph notation. So in the flow graph notation, this it will come into our white box testing. So in white box testing, we should complete our statement coverage, branch coverage, path coverage, and cyclomatic complexity. So we'll see this totally in this into some advanced topic for this manual testing, and it is very important. So we do some practical work on that, and then there will be integration testing. Integration, see the topic whatever mentioned, it will be this not one one order form, it is some in order. So we will when we are starting the training, so we'll do some systematic way where we can follow that develop for software, and also we are following our testings. So the integration testing coming into 26 topic, but integration testing should come into top level, because the integration here, the topic mentioned here, integration testing, because this is a white box testing. Integration, you can say that's white box testing, that where we can following our top down and bottom up approaches, okay, implementable approach and big bang and integration method, like each application developed with a small unit. So when developer develop that applications, they do some unit testing, and after getting successful executable unit, they will integrate multiple unit, more than one unit, and so after doing integration, they also confirm with his testing. But also this is our responsibility for QA to do one round of integration testing. This is system integration testing, and in system integration testing we are having two kind of approaches. There will be one is a top down approach and second is a bottom up approach, and the combination of these two approach we are called as a hybrid approach. Okay, and then lastly there will be requirement traceability matrix. So requirement traceability matrix means after testing our application, and also when we create that application, the test cases and the FSD, we should prepare matrix, like each according to the business requirement, and our whatever test case we have prepared, and the test execution report. So that should be matching it together. There will be no difference or no, and there nothing to get between all the three documents, because when we creating this document, the disability matrix, means we mapped together of each other, means whatever we are coming to for from client side, we can prepare our BRD, FSD, and the technical documents to be just in test cases. So we should cover everything, and then we can prepare matrix as per his functionality wise, performance wise, security wise, and also the compatibility wise. So all thing we have to create a matrix. We can trace everything is completed or not. So overall, we should see how can we follow in the process of manual testing. So this is our topic, and it will take only 12 hours to complete. So do you have any query?
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, so this is your topic. So if suppose you are, as I said, if they will send you the course content, if suppose they will not able to send you, so you can also tell me and I will send you. And
what's your email ID?
Hello, I have sent it the course content to you, Ms. Amit.
Okay.
I have sent it, please check your mail.
Okay. So this much information should be good for any tester, you say?
For manual tester, this topic, whatever topic I am preparing here, so everything is completed for manual testing,
Will you show me any testing in live projects or some examples?
Yes, we can go with live project only. We are not having such a demo project or some QA project. We are having live project. I am live project, so we can go with live assignment.
Okay, fine. So what time you will be available? Will be coming every day, or how it will be? How many days you will be able to finish?
It will finish in 12 hours, so if suppose you are taking every day 1 hour, so it will complete in 12 days. So see, next week in 23rd and 26th, I think that will some technical issue with me, because I am shifting my place. So I am moving from one place to another place, so I have to take a new connection of internet, so that will be one issue I can get. So that will be better. It will be better if suppose we will start on 29th.
You start from from 10 days from now, you are saying? Today's 19th,
yes, right? Today's 19th, after 10 days, if suppose we will start, so it will be great. There will be no any concern or anything issue for me, because when I am shifting 24, so I will take connection, and it will take 2 days to proper connectivity.
Okay. So okay, let me check with Ganesh too, and I will ask him what's there. It was a good thing. I will go over all this stuff, and then we'll see how it goes.
Yes, definitely.
Yes.
So this time is okay, or you should also having some more time?
Yes. I think one more question, your name?
My Basant.
Yeah, Basant. I just want to know, this is, we are doing manual testing. Will you give me some automation tools to testing?
Yes, I can provide. Yes, I can provide you this training also, because Selenium is one functional testing tools, and QTP is also.
Okay.
Yeah. So, also I'm providing those things, but for this automation training program, you should first speak with Ganesh. then we can also include those topic with this training program also.
Yeah, let me we'll see how it goes. I will look into it, and I'll ask Ganesh also to at least give me this topic, what all you are going to cover, so that you know I would know what you are covering and what I need basically. Because I know what all you have done, pretty much I have the concept because I have been using this. I'll tell him to give me all the topic. I will go through myself, and I would really like to have go through the automotive tools too. So accordingly, we'll go there. Go from there. Then you'll be available after 29th, you said, right?
Yes, sir. 29th, yeah.
Okay, Basant. It was nice talking to you. It was a good, good thing. So let's see. We'll get in touch from Ganesh, I guess.
Yes. Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you. May we end the session now?
Yeah, we can. So, are you sending me at least? Give me what all he's going to cover me.
Okay.
And then later we can talk more.
Okay, we can. Me or Ganesh will communicate with you, Hamid, and I will just let you know what all you need and everything, okay?
Yeah, and give me all the syllabus, what all you are going to cover me, because I know some of them, what I'm going to do. It was like briefing for me. And from there we can go then.
Okay, that's fine. That sounds good. Okay.
So yeah, because I would like to go for more of automated testing tools too.
Okay. We'll just communicate in a better manner from tomorrow, and we'll just clear off everything. Okay.
Sure.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Good night.
Wish you all the same.
Thank you.
Okay, Mr. Prabhu.
Yeah.
Okay, good night. You have already left.